expect from AC? Have no expectations. Literally, there is nothing I can tell you to prepare you for what you're about to experience in the next 2 years.
Honestly, I feel like everybody's gonna say it, but don't expect anything.
I think it's really important to have no expectations.
Literally nothing, because AC will blow any of your expectations out of the park.
Don't expect anything, since everything will be completely new and different.
My first advice is have as few expectations as possible.
A lot of people are probably gonna tell you have no expectations. Let's be real, you're gonna have expectations.
In the best possible way, any idea of AC that you have right now, it's not gonna be that. It's gonna be so different to whatever you think.
Amazing people from all over the world.
Expect to be overwhelmed when you first get there.
New cultures, new languages. It can be tough sometimes, so it's demanding academically, mentally, and socially.
What you should definitely expect from AC is chaos.
You should expect AC to challenge you out of your comfort zone, and you should have a lot of fun.
Honestly, everything and more.
AC is not easy. Expect to work for things, because you're really gonna have to work for things if you want them, because things aren't just handed to you on a plate.
Socks. Lots of socks.
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 Honestly, socks.
Lots of socks and underwear.
I don't want to say pack socks, but pack socks.
As many socks as you can fit into your suitcase, honestly.
I'll show you guys. I'll come back with all my socks. Like, no, you won't. Like, I've checked the washing machines. I was that person. I tried and they still go missing. So as many socks and underwear as you can bring.
I'd say a good laundry bag to carry around your laundry is really important.
I also suggest you pack swimsuits.
I would also bring a flag. We like our flags at AC, so definitely do that.
Instrument if you want, bring a speaker. Also, probably a cowboy hat, I'd say. Because why not?
Pack really warm clothes, so it's to wouldn't mind ruining, and boots.
Boots.
Definitely welly boots.
Like, just anything that's water resistant, mud resistant.
The best thing I packed, hands down, and a lot of my co-years tease me for this, I packed these green wellies here. And so yeah, they're awesome because they keep you pretty warm, they're waterproof, they're easy to wash.
Bring pictures or stuff to decorate your dorm with, because it really won't feel like home unless you decorate it.
You realize really quickly that you probably just need sweats and a hoodie. Don't overpack. Don't pack all of your nicest clothes. You will have a hard time in the airport, and you will have a hard time in your dorm because there isn't that much space. During the summer, you're gonna have a hard time trying to put everything into your suitcase to get back home. So please don't overpack.
Probably a few more sweaters, I'd say. Like, you can never have too many because they do go missing. Laundry things.
Utensils, cups, mugs.
So I think the main important thing for me is things that remind you of home. So maybe your favorite mug, your favorite bowl, posters that you have at home, things to decorate your room and make them really lively and comfortable. That will help with homesickness, and also it will like show your character. A practical thing, a plug extender, because then you get a few extra plugs, because some houses have less.
You're gonna start missing home cooked meals and home food. So whether it be chips or like nuts or crackers or instant ramen or whatever it is that you bring, please bring something from your home, because it's really nice to have something to snack on that reminds you of home throughout the year, when all you're going to be eating for the rest of the year is AC food.
We do a lot of sharing at the school, so if you guys, you know, want to bring a little extra so your roommates or friends could try, that's always like really appreciated. And, like, snacks, spices, tea.
Please bring your camera gear. There's also a lot of organizations in the school that require you to, you know, record all the brilliant memories that you're going to make. And it would help ever so much if you brought your camera gear. If you've got a drone, if you've got those tripods, your camera itself, obviously, that would be immensely helpful.
If you ever found yourself in need of an extra pair of boots or an extra jacket, you can always count on our swap shop, which is a really nice and sustainable shop that sells at really cheap prices.
Yeah. The best thing ever. It's basically like a secondhand clothing store on campus where everyone takes their old clothes that they don't want, and then you can buy any clothes there for just £1, so it's super cheap.
And if you are on a scholarship, partial or full, They will provide you with little coupons where you can get them for free.
And we also have a college shop on campus where we can buy toiletries, we can buy snacks, noodles,
or whatever you need basically. So shampoo, razors. They also have merch, books, notebooks, whatever. So if you forget anything, I promise you the school will have it for you.
The weather. With Wales, the sunny days are really sunny and the rainy days are really rainy, but there's kind of usually a constant breeze, so it kind of feels cold even if the sun's out.
Since I'm from Canada, I didn't find it super cold.
Definitely sunnier than you think it is. The weather's actually quite decent most of the time.
South Wales is a rainy, cold place.
If you are from the tropics, hello. The weather in Wales is going to be shocking. If you can, I would advise pack warm clothes. You are gonna need them.
Whew, this one's fun.
Ooh, that's a touchy subject.
The IB, there's gonna be difficult times. It's hard, but I wouldn't stress about it too much or put too much pressure on yourself. As long as you try your hardest, that's the best you can do and you're doing your best. And personally, I would say AC is about the experience and learning more about yourself as well as the world and others.
Pick the subjects that you like and that you need for your future plans.
Guys, don't worry about first term. First term is do anything you possibly can. Those exams do not matter, okay? They do, but they don't, okay? Not yet. But do as much as you possibly can so you can get the whole UWC experience.
The first couple terms in your first year are such a great opportunity to get ahead with the syllabus. Like, if you really want to go for that high grade in the IB, get ahead with the content because there is minimal assignments set to you in first and second term, whereas end of second term, summer holidays, third term, fourth term, like, you're going to be so overwhelmed, there's going to be no time to catch up with the syllabus because the pure amount of coursework and deadlines you're going to have to do are just going to take up all of your free time.
But always keep a healthy balance between your social life, your study schedule, and your sleeping schedule. That's really important.
Regarding the three S's, sleep, study, and social, you'll perfectly find your balance. So the first term is gonna be tough, but I promise you, by second term, you will have it down.
It's possible to have a social life and still get good grades and hand your work in on time. I think one of the biggest pieces of advice I could give somebody, and I wish somebody had given to me, was figure out your priorities. Really, like, when you get there and you kind of get a feeling of like what your life is going to be like there, figure out how you're going to be able to manage it all.
But with that said, those priorities also shift during the school year, so that's okay as well.
You know, it's really, really okay to just take yourself off to bed much earlier than everyone else so you can get a good night's sleep. And that means you'll have a lot more fun socializing and you'll be able to do your studies. But AC is demanding and you need to look after yourself.
With the IB, just surround yourself with people that want to achieve as high a level as you do. And in that way, you guys will study together, you'll develop study guides and stuff like that. And you'll do very well.
Try to get to know as many people as you can.
Talk to anyone.
Be the first person to reach out. Don't wait for somebody to reach out to you because they might not, and they might be thinking the same thing you're thinking, you know?
You're around people 24/7, you're around the same people all the time, and a family forms so quickly. Just be kind to people and be interested in them.
Don't worry about making friends.
We all accept and love you for the way that you are. One thing I would just recommend is be yourself. Don't try fitting in. Everyone will fall in love with who you are.
Don't be intimidated by your second years. I remember my first few weeks there, I was quite shy and I was too afraid to speak to them. But what I didn't realize is that they actually were so excited to meet us, and they had been waiting for us for such a long time, and that they actually cared about us so much. And so don't be afraid to come speak to us. We're not scary, we're not angry, we're just probably sleep deprived.
We want to be able to help you in any way possible. So when you come to AC, it is going to be kind of intimidating because we already seem so accustomed to the AC life while you guys are new and still figuring out your way. So if you just keep yourself to the first year population, it's fine, but there are so many interesting stories that us second years have to share with you guys. So please do talk to us. We're really excited to have you.
Of course, have respect for them, but
trust us, like, just
keep that in mind. Don't have expectations of who you're gonna become friends with, because honestly, the greatest friendships are the ones you don't expect.
Friends, don't chill, man.
It's gonna be chill, it's gonna be calm.
when you come, just relax, like, there's loads of time to make friends, and don't worry too much about finding the cool people. I mean, remember, this is a UWC. Literally everyone here is cool in about 5 different ways. So,
I mean, obviously one of the things you expect from AC is diversity. So try to make friends with, you know, people you wouldn't meet at home.
Honestly, once you get to AC, everyone's so nice and you make friends instantly. Even if you're someone who's shy and like find it difficult to talk to new people, you will always find your group because there's so many like diverse people and so many people with different interests. You will always find people who are like you and people who you get along with.
I recommend you step out of your comfort zone. Talk to as many people as possible. Being in a place like AC, where you are surrounded by many people from all over the world, it'll be a bit silly to just speak to the people that speak your language.
Also, if you're shy, don't worry, I'm shy and I found friends and other shy people found friends. It's a whole big mess. Honestly, they're gonna become your family, you're gonna have fights with them, and they will be there for you when you need them. You just have to be patient sometimes, you have to speak up about things.
You'll get used to it pretty fast.
You become like your own personal family, but also the house as a whole. You just become so tight. You should expect less privacy, of course.
At first it's really weird. Having 3 roommates, you know, like, it's something that not a lot of people are used to, and that's absolutely fine. You just get used to having like your best friend across the hall or like a house or 2 away from you, you know? You're like, you get used to having your favorite people on the campus just around you all the time.
I think it's really important to get along with your roommates, so spend time with them, talk to them, and get to know them really well. You'll have to slightly lower some of your expectations for cleanliness and privacy. And also, you have to be extra understanding and remember to communicate for any problems you have.
Expect a lot of music, a lot of fun, support, expect a lot of late nights. Yeah, you live together, so you do experience a lot of things together and you create friendships that are really, really, really special.
Don't come too rigid on the way that you kind of live, because being in a dorm with people from different nationalities, different continents, different lifestyles, it is very, like, shocking. You have to be able to accommodate and kind of adapt, so come with an open mind.
Expect to get used to it quite fast. Honestly, when I first arrived there, it was super, super weird. I couldn't sleep for quite a long time knowing there was 3 other people in the same room as me with me 24/7, and I was like really self-conscious. But now I can't. I go back home and it's weird. Like, I don't like sleeping on my own at home now because I'm used to literally spending most of the year sharing a room with 3 other people.
Yeah, throw yourself into things. I think the people who struggle with homesickness are more the people that spend a lot of time alone and in their dorms and without and not interacting with anyone. And that's when you have time to think about home. So keep busy and yeah. It will be fine.
Because after a certain point, your friends become your family.
If you do feel homesick, you always tell someone. You have roommates who become your siblings almost. There's counselors, there's teachers that become your family and your parents as well, your home parents.
Guys, it's a real thing. As much as you don't think, like, I didn't think. I was like, yes, I'm out of here.
And that's completely normal. We all did. But you really don't have to worry. You'll get through them so quickly. As soon as you get to meet all these wonderful people and as soon as you realize that AC is a place you can call home.
You call your families. That'll help you with your homesickness.
I never really got that homesick. I guess just because, especially in the first couple weeks or even a month, you're so busy making new friends, settling in, and the school puts on lots of activities to get you used to it. So you're just always doing fun things. You never really have time to even think about missing home that much.
Of course, there are days where the food isn't great.
Bring as much food as you can from home, literally. Just bring a whole suitcase of food.
So we get 3 meals a day, breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
I was actually pleasantly surprised with the food situation in AC. There are a lot of options. There are vegan and vegetarian options. Lunches are great. You have like 3 different kinds of desserts. And breakfasts are pretty good too, especially brunches. You get hash browns and sausages and they're just amazing.
Every day in your houses, you have to collect, you can go to the kitchen and collect bread and butter, and then you get cheese, eggs and pasta a couple times a week.
If you are used to eat lots of different food and meals, get prepared to only eat potatoes every day. But if you can't bring snacks from your home country and food that you know you won't be able to get here, do it.
This food, you can share with friends and introduce them to your culture, or they'll help you with homesickness.
Make friends with the kitchen staff, okay?
There's some really unique activities at AC just because it is right next to the sea. There's paddle sports, power boating, lifeguarding, just some really fun outdoor activities that are definitely worth signing up for.
So much to do at AC, like, get involved in as many things as you can, perhaps not permanently, but try and explore everything, and then you can commit to the ones you like.
Apart from the CAS activities, of course, which are compulsory, but you often get to choose, we have 5 different councils. Anyone can attend the council meetings. We have Peace Council, Sustainability, Student Council, Wellbeing Council, and Slack Celeste Council.
Also, getting outside your comfort zone. If there's always that thing that you've wanted to do but don't think you have the full capability of doing it, still try it. Give it a try, because AC is meant for you to challenge yourself, is meant for you to go outside your comfort zone, is meant for you to push yourself. And everyone at AC sees something good in someone and wants someone to try it and wants someone to be able to do it. Because who knows, you may be good at it, who knows, you may not be good at it. And if you're not good at it, we practice and we work together as a team and we do it. And we push each other and we help each other out. It's amazing. Your teachers, there's your house parents, which are always there for you. Second years who are always here for you. Your tutors too, they will help you academically and overall anything. There's counselors to talk about if you need someone one-on-one to talk to. Peer listeners, safeguarding if there's anything, they are here for your safety. National committees, you will fall in love with them. Idea of a national committee like I did.
Don't suffer alone, that it's the worst decision you can make in here.
Yeah, so there is support for mental health, there's really great counselors, they're the sweetest people on earth. And of course there's ALN, which is for me is really special. I have ADHD and I do often have trouble planning and making sure that I keep organized and I stay on track of my schoolwork, and they help you going over your notes and make sure you understanding everything. There is great service full of people who can help you with that.
As well as additional learning needs, we also have something called language guides. So for anyone taking a second language, which is mandatory, at AC, you can get paired up with someone who speaks that language you're learning and they can help you like revise with classes, kind of just like practice and stuff, which is super, super helpful.
You gain such a huge support network from everywhere, and it ranges from just your roommates and your housemates to your house parents who are really like your parents, to teachers, to kitchen and cleaning staff. You know, you see them every single day and you gain such a huge network at IB Buddy, as I said, and second years that can help you through anything. So whatever problem you're having, there'll be someone on campus you can talk to. And I think my best advice is to just open up to everybody, be willing to have a chat, be kind to everybody, and soon enough you'll gain such a strong support network with people that can help you.
Make sure you budget yourself, plan it out for the year. If not, you find yourself February, Valentine's Day. It's time to get something for your dates. You don't have money. So yeah, budget really, like, plan out your stuff. If not, you're gone.
So once you arrive and kind of get an idea of the type of lifestyle you're going to have over the next year, like start budgeting, like your travel, your food, any outings you might have, anything you might want to buy that you couldn't pack with you, like just start budgeting straight away, because otherwise everything catches up with you so fast and you will have no money left. So budget. Congratulations to everyone who got in, because that is absolutely amazing. It's one of the most competitive boarding schools in the world, and you got in, so congrats.
Just have fun, a lot of fun. Thank you.
Everyone is cool, and people recognize that everyone has something unique, and I know it's cheesy, but it's genuinely true. And so please, guys, don't ever do something that you think is gonna get you attention or gonna make you seem cool, because that's just not how it works here. You know, just always be who you are. You will always find people who support you and love you for that.
I think it's really important to normalize that no school is perfect. There's going to be down days, there's going to be high days, and that's completely normal. So if it feels like everybody around you is in some type of utopia and you're the only one not feeling okay, that's completely normal. Trust me, I've been there, so many people have been there, and that's why it's really important to have no expectations and for this experience to be your own, because you really can't expect what's going to happen.
I think the best thing to do is to pay attention during class, settle down and work during the week, because if you can get it out in the week, then you can have fun on the weekends. And also, your second years are always there to help. They've gone through everything you're going through, and so you can find them in the quiet room or the library.
I recommend you take time for yourself. It's really easy in a place like AC to lose everything that connects you with yourself, so don't lose that.
But my advice to you would probably be to make time for yourselves, and that's something that I didn't do for a while, and I had to do it consciously, also because with the fear of missing out, because there's so much going on, you think, oh, I'll do that later and later and later, but don't postpone it, because I found myself getting really tired and not enjoying the things that I was scared of missing out in. So make sure you make time for yourselves, and can't wait to see you guys.